And what's intimate, not call up on what on them. But it's a real people in that realm of God that ain't fornicating, ain't lusting, ain't shaking. I'm tired of folks preaching this junk, talking about you can live the way you want to live and grace covered it all. But what you mean to tell me grace covered it all? Well, now my Bible tell me, and you know they always say, well, you know you're going to fall. Well, my Bible tell me, now unto him who is able to keep me from falling. Tomorrow. It's gonna be some people in this earth realm that's getting ready to let go on the inside, get on the outside, and they're gonna be able to stand still for God. There's gonna be some miracles that's gonna be working in the church world. There's gonna be a shaking in the church. There's gonna be some power out. Well, if I come to church this day, I ain't gonna prophesy to no homemonger, no backbiter. What you need a cop for is popped in the cut last night. What you need a house for, and you're gambling every night. How can you come to church and work for God? Don't even touch the mic if you're a fornicator. There's gonna be some people finna get some on them. That's why we're put in them. They're gonna be able to sustain and live right and stay in a place with God. How many people want that Holy Ghost on you? I'm tired of the right ghost and the wrong spirit. I'm tired of being able to speak in tongues and can't live right. I'm tired of being able. I mean, you wanna tell God, keep the tongues, keep the gift, keep everything until I can get this under subjection. I need something to get on me. I need something to help me to live right. I'm tired of leaving home, sleeping with somebody else's wife or somebody who's that got more lust than a dog got me. A whole bunch of peer popping, tobacco chewing, cocaine dipping, whole chasing, free basing, chopper busting, club hopping, fools in the church. But you feel like you got God, but you got some in you, but ain't got none on you. I need something holy. I need something that's gonna keep me happy. I need something that likes to get cut off, or maybe to smile. But how do you find the next one that ain't gonna be looking for gifts? Ain't gonna be looking to be balling. Ain't gonna be looking to be the number one stunner, big baller, shot caller, cross on the neck big enough for Abraham to lay on. But it won't preach the cross, because in order to preach the cross, you gotta preach self-denial. But they don't want to preach that no more. Everybody want money, everybody want fame, everybody want this, everybody want that. But don't give me no money, don't give me that fame. Let one sin me get on me. I want that Holy Ghost. You got some people that gon' walk like him. You got some people. Dispense upon me. And that's what happened in the church world. The devil fooling people. He making people fall away at the last minute. People is leaving churches that full of the Holy Ghost, going to these traditional churches where they tell you you can lead the way you want to live. But guess what? There was so many in the upper room on the day of Pentecost. And guess what happened then? He had to wait till so many get out before he let go what he had for the people. And these people right here, they're not going to be sick in no car. They're not going to be sick in no money. We ain't talking about no fake praises. Get up here on the praise team and gossip about everybody and talk about praise and worship. Somebody, you've been in the presence of God. Well, no, you haven't, because the Bible tells me that the real presence of God, the ministers couldn't even stand the minister. What kind of presence you been in? You got the right ghost, but the wrong spirit. You better get back in prayer and get on your knees and check yourself before you wreck yourself. I need what seven to get on that. It ain't about your money and about your car and about your Gator boots and your Gucci shoes. But I want to know how many people you done heal. How many people you gonna blind the eyes you to open up? How many hoes done got delivered? Many of y'all want the Holy Ghost. I need something to get on. I want to be able to live right. I want to be able to walk right. I'm tired of laying out with somebody that ain't my husband and can't control me. You going all the way down. Speaking in tongues going down. Don't want to do it but can't stop the clock. Somebody's even possessed. Somebody can't control your own flesh. You better check it before you wreck it. Jesus. Lord, don't do it to me. God, don't let me call out every name in the church and have the wrong presence upon me. God, don't let me not know your presence. And then when I get behind the real presence, I blaspheme it because I done been in the wrong presence. God, don't let that happen to me. Just because I'm messed up, don't let me think everybody messed up. I need something that's in me to get on me. I needed to get on me. He kept in John the second chapter. Now watch this now. When Jesus turned water to wine, I'm getting ready to go. I said, the Holy Ghost, God gonna let me work some miracles. God gonna work some miracles through me. I see God's hand moving. I ain't never been nothing. I'm a nobody. Take your eyes on me and put your eyes on God, and you're gonna see God and you watch God move like never before. God said, John the second chapter, turning the water into wine. Anytime you look at water, you think about spirit. That symbolizes the spirit, water, clear spirit. I mean, that will punch you. But he said, I'm going to pour some out upon all flesh in the last days. Sons and daughters should prophesy. Now, it's something to have some in you, but it's another thing to have some on you. Because when something get on you, you can't control it. How many times we done lied and came to church and gossip and come to church and still can operate and everybody shout? Well, the people that shout to your false presence, you know who fornicated in. That's how prophets work. See, that's how prophets operate. Now, see, if I was to come to church messed up and I get to shouting and jumping, running down the aisles, all the people that shouting behind me, some people would be sitting down. I say, y'all come on to the altar. I know what's up. I know what's wrong. Something messed up.